Hey guys, welcome back. This is Archana here, and today in this video I'm going to show you how to recycle this DO bottle. And I don't want this bottle to get open, so that's why I'm gluing down the bottle cap using glue. If you follow me on my social media or YouTube, then you might have noticed that I use gesso to prime my project in mixed media, but here I thought that I will be using chalk paint to do so. I'm applying generous amount of chalk paint using palette knife, and this way I will be cover entire bottle. And also this is one of my favorite technique to create texture. The shade I'm using here is called greasy charcoal. And this is how my bottle looks like after it dries completely. I never tried stenciling on bottle, and since, you know, as I said earlier, this project is completely experimental, so I thought why not to use stencil. So I choose this stencil. This stencil is called Geometrical Patterns from Crafty Scrapper. I secure this stencil edges using masking tape so that next when I add shimmer paste, the stencil will stay in place. And the shade I'm using here is called Jade. I'll link down all the materials used in this video in the description box below, so don't forget to check that out. And I'm just going to cover bottom part of this bottle using this stencil. And after removing the stencil, I'm just using palette knife to spread the shimmer paste all over the bottle, just to put everything together. And the rest part is quite self-explanatory, so I'm just going to speed up the process little bit. I just love the way I got finish here on this bottle, and I don't want this look to get ruined, so I'm not going to do much fancy here. And you know, there is a beauty in simplicity, so I'm just going to retain that simplicity by adding only these two metal leaves and a little amount of thread around the bottle cap. Here I again covered this metal embellishments and thread using greasy charcoal chalk paint. Thank you. forgot to mention here that I also added shimmer paste on the thread and metal embellishments. And after the layer dries completely, I use gesso to highlight the project. Now highlighting with gesso is great way to pop out all the elements which we added on our project. And here I use fixative spray to seal this entire project. Hope you guys have enjoyed this process. I will be back soon. Till then, bye bye, take care and happy crafting.